Welcome, Impactful Parents. It's time for the Impactful Parenting Podcast, where I give you parenting tips and resources to make you a more impactful parent to your school-aged child. I am your host, Christina Campos. Today, we're going to talk about the importance of maintaining your sense of identity. You know, that person you were before you had children. Oh, I know. It feels like a million years ago, but it is super important to maintain that person that you were pre-parenthood. So today, I'm going to have you dig a little deeper into yourself. Let's start with asking, who are you? A parent? An accountant? A business owner? No. See, those are all things that you do. So often we get caught up in what we do. We forget who we are. I spent many years trying to be the best mom and the best wife and the best teacher I could be. I put all my energy into it because I enjoyed serving my family and my students. The problem was, when my marriage ended and my career became increasingly more difficult, I couldn't recognize myself in the mirror. Now, this made me realize that I had focused on everyone else for so long that I lost who I was. Stay-at-home parents fall into the same trap a lot because their whole world becomes their children. And every day, I see parents and entrepreneurs and married couples forget the why of their routine. In my opinion, a midlife crisis is sometimes a product of this phenomenon. One day, we just wake up and say, what? How did I get here? What did this happen? So we must continue to feed the person we are with things that we love and remember that person you were before kids. So I'm going to ask you again, who are you? Who are you when the kids are grown and retirement sets in? Who are you when no one is looking? Who are you when you're alone for a day with no responsibilities? Now, I know that hardly ever happens, right? But it's so important to think about that. When you have nothing else, what would you do? Because those things that you choose really kind of show who you are. To be a better parent, you must be your authentic self. Your children need to see the unique you. It's by feeding your unique you that will bring happiness into your life and allow you to be the best version of yourself, and therefore, a better parent. And isn't that what you want for your kids? Don't you want them to have a parent that's happy and fulfilled and not just worn down by their routine? Don't you want your kids to be proud of their unique selves also? So role modeling teaches them to be proud of who they are and not embarrassed by it or exhausted by their own routine that they may have established. And then once we know that person we see in the mirror, we're proud of that adult that we became, and we find more authentic use of our time because the things that we do should be a reflection of who we are. So again, who are you? For me, when I lost myself and I was looking at myself in the mirror and trying to regain my identity back, I started looking to things that I would do just for myself, just for me, outside of parenthood. This is super important. This is how I rebuilt myself. And some of the things that I found out is that I'm a giver. I love giving. I need to help people. It's part of who I am. It's why I became a teacher. And now that I'm not teaching, this is why I founded The Impactful Parent. I love to help people. If I'm not giving, if I'm not trying to help others, I actually feel just yucky. It's something that makes me feel good about myself and has, over time, really became part of who I am. I also found out that I love tennis and I love to play that particular sport. I also love traveling. And these are all things that I would do when no one is looking and no one is around. These are things that I would choose. I love to read. I love just going for walks. These kind of questions of what would I do if I had nothing else going on, no responsibilities, and everything was really my choice, these are the things I want you to think about. And write them down. Yeah, write them down. There's something special that happens when you put a piece of paper and your thought together with a pencil and put it on a sticky note or any little thing like that, but tape it to your mirror and it reminds you of the things that you love, the things that you want to do. So when you do have an extra hour of your time or a free day, look to the piece of paper and figure out what are you going to do. Don't do laundry. Don't take that extra nap unless you really need it. Go do something that fulfills your soul. It's also about not putting imaginary boundaries on yourself. And this happens to us all the time. We do it with not even realizing it. We say things like, well, I would do that, but I can't. Or I just don't have time for it. Or I'm not that kind of person. You are capable of doing whatever you want. You are capable of finding time for the things that are really important to you. Even if it's a baby step, baby steps are progress. So find that time when you can take those things that you really want to do and create them into action. Don't put those imaginary boundaries on yourself where you're saying, I can't, or I won't, or I'm not that kind of person. Those are boundaries you're putting on your own limitations. They're limitations you're putting on your own capabilities, and you have none. You can do whatever you want. It may take time. It may take a lot of effort. It may take baby steps to get there, but you can do it. I promise you can. So, who are you? What would you do if you had a free moment, a free hour, a free day? What fills your soul? And let's work toward those goals. You got this, parents. I'm just here to help. Thank you for listening today. Remember to subscribe and share this podcast with a friend. And don't forget, the Impactful Parenting Podcast is an extension of the Impactful Parent community. So go to the Impactful Parent website and sign up for a 30-day challenge. Browse the free resources or register for the weekly newsletter so that you don't miss a parenting tip that can help you and your family. Thanks for listening today and go to theimpactfulparent.com. See you next episode.